Aristotle thought it was obvious that a stone dropped from a moving chariot would fall behind the chariot. From this, he deduced that the earth is not moving, because he knew that a stone thrown straight up in the air wouldn't get left behind. He believed that he had no need to experiment, because logical thought would lead him to the correct conclusions. However, the modern scientific method holds the view that all theory must be tested by experiment. And we know that the Earth is rotating. Aristotle's deduction was wrong because it was based on a false premise. If he had been prepared to experiment, he would have seen that he was wrong. Well, here's something Aristotle might have found interesting. I've got a small cannon here with a firing mechanism which can fire a small ball like this vertically upwards. So I'll just load it into the cannon, and when I fire the mechanism with this remote switch, the ball travels straight up and down, landing back at the cannon. Now, what would happen to the path the ball takes if the cannon were moving at a constant speed when it's fired? Well, in fact, my cannon is sitting on a device called a linear air track, which enables it to glide on a cushion of air. If I push the glider, it maintains a constant velocity down the track. To perform the experiment, I'll set the glider in motion and remotely fire the cannon. What do you think will happen? So, Aristotle was wrong. The ball still lands by the cannon. And the same thing can happen on the moving Earth. I can throw a ball up and still catch it. Aristotle provided cogent and persuasive arguments, but the experiment shows that one of his basic premises was wrong.